Obeisance to His Holiness Acharya Mahashraman.
Respected Shramanijis.
Greetings to distinguished guests and Deshpremi Bhaiyo and Beno. Fellow countrymen and ladies, don't be alarmed. I'm not going to make a surprise demonetization announcement. I'm going to be talking to you today about the Jain Vishwabharati. Jain Vishwabharati was established by the far-sighted vision of Acharya Tulsi and Acharya Mahapragya in Rajasthan in 1970. Both Acharya Tulsi and Acharya Mahapragya were followers of Acharya Bhikshu, who started the Therapant sect over 250 years ago. What does Therapant mean? Thera means your and Panth means path. So followers of your path. And what does your refer to? Your refers to the supreme souls of the Jain faith. Thera also means 13. And path, as we know, means followers. So when Acharya Bhikshu started the Therapant sect, he had 13 followers. So Therapant can also denote 13 followers. Acharya Mahashraman, he is currently the 11th head of the Therapant sect. He became a monk at the age of 14 years under the blessings of Acharya Mahapragya. Since becoming an Acharya in 2010, he has embarked on a 20,000 kilometers non-violence journey across India and Nepal, propagating violence-free and addiction-free lifestyle to the masses. This year, the Chaturmas, the sojourn during the monsoon season, is in Kolkata, and JVB are planning a trip there in October of this year. There'll be an opportunity to spend time with His Holiness Acharya Mahashramanji, participate in a global Praksha meditation camp, and even visit pilgrim places like Samit Chikarji and Bhavapuri. For further information, please contact some of the JVB volunteers. Jain Vishwabharati, what does JVB mean? J for Jain, followers of Jina, Vishwa, global, and Bharati, denoting knowledge. The aim of JVB is to become a center of excellence for Jain studies. Various monks, nuns, shamans, shamanijis, lay followers, and academics are involved in studying and understanding Jain philosophy. Recently, it has become a hub for the science of living, Jivan Vignan and Praksha Dhyan. The seven core aims are as follows. Shiksha, learning with a difference. As the saying goes, knowledge comes from learning, but wisdom comes from living. The aim is to translate knowledge into the art of living. Seva, service to mankind. This is generic to all faiths across the world. As Mahatma Gandhi said, the best way to find yourself is to lose in the service of others. Sadhana. We all need continuous efforts to reach our goals. Neither strength nor intelligence only are the key to unlock our potential. Sahitya. Researching ancient history. History is important. To know nothing before you are born is to forever remain a child. US President Roosevelt said, the more you know of the past, the better prepared you are for the future. The importance of Jain agams is that they propound timeless truths which are applicable across all ages. Discovery within. The key aphorism of Praksha meditation is Sampi kaye apaga mapaeram. See yourself through yourself. Another aphorism of is apana satya me seja mittim bhuesu na kappaye, which means search truth yourself and be friends to all living beings. This ensures that people don't have blind faith, but empowers each and everyone to believe that you are a drop of water and you can transform yourself into an ocean. Spread values globally. In the materialistic world, companies and organizations strive for global expansion and profitability. On the same note, JVB strives on spreading the message of peace and non-violence globally. The law of nature is such that happiness and peace multiplies when it is divided amongst all. Cultural roots. If our roots are strong, we can weather any storm. There are two things we should give our children. One is roots, and the others are wings to fly. Activities and projects within India. Jain Vishwabharati Institute in India is one of the foremost accredited institutions for an in-depth study of Jain philosophy and comparative religions. The three pillars of Jain philosophy are Samyak Darshan, Gnan, and Charitra. Right perspective of faith, right knowledge, and right conduct. And accordingly, the motto of the institute is right conduct is the essence of right knowledge. In fact, a few people in the UK, including myself, did a distant learning master's course in Jainism, which has ignited the thirst of knowledge to learn more about this pristine philosophy. Mahapragya International School. Respected Shamaniji Pratibha Pragyaji, before she came to the UK for her PhD studies, was head of this school in Tampore. It is involved in the upliftment of rural community who otherwise would not get basic education. There are opportunities for underprivileged children to learn IT skills, which is where the future is heading towards. Ayurvedic Institute. The aim is to focus on researching and manufacturing Ayurvedic medicine, which are known to have beneficial properties without side effects. Nature is the greatest place to heal and recharge. Praksha Meditation. There are numerous Praksha Meditation centers for our well-being and spiritual growth. Respected Shamaniji Pratibha Pragyaji's PhD researched the evolution of Praksha Meditation right from ancient times to medieval ages to modern day adaptations. And she also studied how different ideologies, philosophies, modern science and medicine have synergies with Praksha Meditation, which is a generic meditational technique beneficial to the entire society, not just for the Jains. Therapanth Mahasabha. They have a strong network across India and are actively involved in looking after the welfare of monks and nuns and expanding overseas, propagating the message of the Therapanth saints. Now, JVB is a global institute. JVB has international centers in USA and UK. In the USA, there are JVB centers in Houston, New Jersey, and Florida. In fact, in Florida, respected Shamanijis have been affiliated with the Florida International University in Miami for Jain Studies program. Isn't it heart-rendering that Jainism has become a recognized faith, inspiring many youth, many of whom are not from the Jain background, to learn more about this unique religion? Gone are the days when many of us used to classify ourselves as a branch of Hinduism, and now Jain studies are integrated into the academic curriculum. We also have with us here Professor Peter Flugel from the School of African and Oriental Studies, who was the supervisor of respected Shamaniji for her PhD studies. Him and his research students' in-depth knowledge of the Jain philosophy would put all of us to shame. Who are the Shamanijis? We know that Jain monks and nuns are called sadhus and sadhvis, who take major vows of ascetic life and traditionally do not use any means of transportation to travel besides foot. So, in that case, what is the difference between a sadhu, sadhvi, and shamans and shamanijis? Acharya Tulsi realized that there was a need for a new category of monks and nuns called shamans and shamanijis, who had some relaxation of rules, such as those of travel, food, use of modern technology such as computers and phones. It was in 1980 that the first shamans and shamanijis were initiated. When their guru feels that the shamanijis have themselves been spiritually evolved and adequately served the society, he would then initiate them into a fully fledged sadhus and sadhvis who would then not travel outside India. Friends, can you imagine the days of the early 1900s when the initial immigrants came to this country and they struggled to uphold their cultural values and beliefs? Diet was a problem, to now where we have got Jain saints walking the streets of London. We are indeed living in a blessed era. JVB London. The presence of respected Shamnijis in London has been here over the past 20 years. We have a committee of 8 members and many devotees and volunteers all committed to further the vision of JVB for personal transformation, spiritual uplift and the welfare of the society. The activities. Every Sunday, we have regular Sunday sessions with respected Shamnijis who expound on Jain texts such as Adhyatma Padavali, Mananusashnam, very complex texts but all explained in English. Periodically, there are workshops on Preksha meditation and well-being, special camps for women's health, and many more. All religious festivals are appropriately celebrated through mantras, jap, pratikaman. Should people have depression, doubts, dilemmas, all of them can be dealt with Shamnijis through one-to-one meetings and personal counseling. There are children classes taught by respected Shamnijis for their holistic development, teaching sutras, stories, mantras and meditation. From my own personal experience, my 3 young children from the age of 3 years were learning Bhaktamar Sutra from respected Shamnijis and they become quite adept at reciting these sutras. It is common observation that during happy days, one does not turn to spirituality, but when trouble strikes, one resorts to any form of spiritual support. Respected Shamnijis have visited people at hospitals and even given last rites to people at their final stages of their journey. To move on with equanimity and peace. One striking example is that of an English lady called Julia, who had a strong affinity for Indian culture and values, and during her terminal stages of cancer in UK, asked respected Shamnijis to help her. She said, "I cannot go to India, but India has come to me." And through the power of mantra recitation, she passed away peacefully, as you can see in the photograph. Respected Shamnijis are interested in the welfare of one and all. They bless us during happy occasions, birth naming ceremonies, marriages, housewarming, and even mangalic for important events and for exams. They represent Jains for all interfaith events and have represented Jains at the Parliament and the Vatican, and even having the audience with the Pope. Respected Shamnijis have visited across UK and universities. In short, Shamnijis assist us not from right from cradle to cremation, and not even primarily from the cradle, but from conception to cremation. Lastly, respected Shamnijis represent monks and nuns. No Jain scholar or expert can act as a proxy. They walk the talk, we simply talk the talk. JVB is unique amongst all other Jain organizations, having the ambition of having a permanent base for Jain monks and nuns. On that note, I'm happy to inform you that we recently paid deposit on a property in Harrow and further details will be given by Vijal Mehta. Shamnijis are an integral part of the community. They have no sectarian communal bias. They are all proficient in English who can greatly assist our children. To that end, I'm ever so grateful to His Holiness Acharya Shri to bless us with Shamnijis for our spiritual upliftment, because as Pope Francis says, take care of your spiritual life as this is the backbone of everything we do and everything we are. Om Arham.
Oh my God.